Before flying any plane, it's important to make sure that the aircraft is in a good general condition, with no obvious defects or any other issues. That's why the pre-flight inspection and walk-around is a very important part of every flight. In this video, I'm going to show you BAA Training's procedures on how to do the pre-flight inspection and walk-around on this beautiful Tecnam P2002. The aircraft is now in a cold and dark state, since it hasn't flown for a couple of days by now. And this is the state we usually find our airplanes in when we come to the airport to fly. And the first thing I do when I get to an airplane that I have to pre-flight is I always drain the left and right wing tanks to make sure that the fuel is not contaminated with any water or any other substances. And after turning on the fuel selector to the right tank, I also drain the fuel in the nose section of the aeroplane. And if that's all good, I start off with the cabin inspection. First, we're making sure that the parking brake is actually set. We don't want to start rolling into the fence at any point. And then we check all of the aircraft documents all the way around, making sure we have a current chart, the AFM and all the documents, and that they're also still valid. Then we also make sure that our mass and balance is within limits, but at this point in 99% of all cases, the mass imbalance is already completed and signed off by the flight instructor of the day. So that's basically always completed already. Then we just check the condition of the safety belts, just making sure that there's no rips or any tears or any loose ends flying around that shouldn't be flying around. Next up, we make sure that the magnetos are set to off with the key extracted. I don't even have the key with me today, so that's not a danger. And then we turn the master switch on, checking the voltage of the batteries and also the ammeter, which should show a discharge. It's basically on zero. And also taking a quick glance on the fuel gauges. Both tanks are full in our case. Then we select the flaps and put them to full. This will help us during the walk around. And now we also turn on strobe lights, the landing lights and the nav lights, basically all of the lights. And since we usually do the pre-flight inspection on our own, that means I now have to climb out of the plane and check all the lights. Okay, we're making sure that our landing light is on, making sure that on the left wing, the red navigation light and the strobe are working. And then we're moving along to the tail light. Sometimes a bit tough to see, but our white tail light is also working. And then just the same thing on the right-hand side again, strobes are working. And the green navigation light is also working. And then here on this wing, we're just gonna test the stall warning, and we're just making sure that when the switch gets activated, we can hear this sound. It works. And now to make sure that the battery doesn't run flat, we'll turn off all the lights again, and also on the other side, we will turn off the battery master. And now we're just going to take a look at our emergency equipment, making sure that the fire extinguisher is here, emergency hammer, ELT, and also making sure that everything is secure. And that completes the internal inspection. Now we'll go on to the walk around. And now for the external inspection. Its main purpose is to just check the general condition of the aircraft, checking for any cracks or any other defects, excessive play or excessive friction. So it's really just to get an overview of the condition of the plane. And we start off on the pilot side, and we first go and visually check the fuel tank, making sure the level roughly corresponds with the instruments. And then we're just gonna go along and check the entire leading edge of the wing and also the upper and lower surface, making sure that there's no cracks and that all rivets are in place. And we just do that walking along the entire length of the wing until we get to our pitot tube and static ports. We will remove the cover and make sure that they're in good condition and that they are not obstructed. And then moving along to the wingtip, checking the general condition, checking the lights, making sure they're not broken, and then also verifying that the fuel tank vent is unobstructed. And then we move along to the aileron, checking the aileron movement, making sure that the linkages all look good and that nothing is loose. And then we go a bit further along and check the flaps. We can't move them since they're electric, but also just making sure that the linkages look okay and that the surface of the flaps is not damaged. I have to kneel down quite a bit. We can also check the flaps from this side, but also mainly the underside of the plane and also the condition of the tire, the brake discs, and the landing gear in general. And then we also take a look to see that the tire hasn't suffered any creep that has gone unnoticed. Everything is looking good here. So we continue onwards with the fuselage, also just making sure it's in good condition, and the leading edge of the vertical stabilizer, and then moving to our stabilator, making sure that the leading edge and all the other surfaces look good and undamaged. And then we also check that it moves freely with no excessive friction, and also we make sure that the linkages all look good and unobstructed. Then we also take a look at our rudder and the vertical stabilizer in general, just making sure all the rivets are in place and checking the same things on this side of the stabilator. Lots of bug strikes, but that should be fine. And then also checking the tail skid, making sure it's still well attached, and the underside of the fuselage, that it is undamaged. And now we basically do the exact same thing as on the other side, again on this side. So we check the wheel, we check the flaps, we check the aileron, the leading edge, the fuel tank vent, and also of course the entire wing structure. And we also make sure that the fuel level again roughly corresponds with what we have seen on the instruments. And once we've completed all of that, we move forward, take a look at the nose, and now we check the nose gear, check the tire and the general condition. We also check all of the air intakes, making sure that they're unobstructed. And then we move up a bit, check the propeller for any defects or any cracks, making sure that's looking all good, and the spinner. And then I usually like to do this first, opening up, taking a look on this side at the engine. First, checking the coolant level, making sure it's between min and max, which it is, which is good. And then just seeing if I can spot any leaks or anything that's loose that's not supposed to be loose. I'm no mechanic, so I'm not gonna change anything here, but just making sure that everything looks right is the basic idea, which it does. So we can close this side again, making sure to properly lock it. And then I switch over to the other side. Doing the same basic visual inspection, making sure there's no loose pieces flying around anywhere or any oil dripping where it's not supposed to drip. And then I will open the oil filler cap, take it off. And now, since this plane has a dry sump, we unfortunately always, to get a correct reading for the oil, have to crank the propeller manually. But to demonstrate, we'll turn the propeller in the direction of the engine.
Like that. Okay.
Okay, so we just have to crank the prop, and I've helped now. So let's wait until we hear the sound. Perfect. And now we will pull out the dipstick, wipe it off once to get proper reading. Now we'll put the dipstick back in again, making sure it's in all the way, and pulling it out. And now you can see that the oil is fine. It's in between the two indentations, which signify minimum and maximum. So we would be good to fly. Let's clean this off again. Put the dipstick back in and close the oil filler cap. And now we can close the engine cowling again, making sure it's properly locked and latched. And that concludes the walk around and pre-flight inspection of this plane. Now all that's left to do is remove the tie downs, remove the chocks, and push the plane out onto the apron and starting the engine. But that's unfortunately it for this video. I hope you enjoyed. As usual, if you have any feedback or any questions, just let me know. Thanks a lot also very much to my team that came out here today to help me film. And thank you very much for watching. See you next time.